all the king's men, elders, who obtained a good report. Copyright 2022 Olubusayo Aina. All rights reserved. The characters and events portrayed in this book are fictitious. Any similarity to real persons, living or dead, is coincidental and not intended by the author. No part of this book may be reproduced or stored in a retrieval system or transmitted in any form or by any means, electronic, mechanical, photocopying, recording or otherwise, without express written permission of the publisher. ISBN -13 to 9781234567890. ISBN -10 to 1477123456. ISBN 9,798,715,220,349. Cover design by Art Painter. Library of Congress control number 2,018,675,309. Printed in the United States of America. Contents. Title page. Copyright. Prologue. Introduction. Chapter 1 Abel. Chapter 2 Enoch. Chapter 3 Noah. Chapter 4 Abraham. Chapter 5 Rahab. Conclusion. About the author. Prologue. Now faith are the words that introduced the 11th chapter of the book of Hebrews. For faith is the foundational truth of every converse we have with God. Faith starts our relationship with Him, sustains it, and fuels His move in our lives till we meet Him in glory. As it is written, "But without faith it is impossible to please Him, for he that cometh to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him." Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6. To walk with God, faith is an indispensable requirement, and some understood this. These select few were considered to be privileged men, loved by God. Men who became heroes. Heroes who became elders. Elders with a good report. These ones are the examples shown to us. Shining stars whose lives should encourage all. Resolute, unwavering. Rare gems they were. Give praise to the Father for all the king's men. Introduction. I saw in the night visions, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven, and came to the Ancient of Days, and they brought him near before him. And there was given him dominion and glory, and a kingdom that all people, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion which shall not pass away, and his kingdom that which shall not be destroyed. Daniel chapter 7 verses 13 to 14. Daniel's words couldn't be clearer. There is only one recognized king in all creation. He, who has been anointed to rule, by the authority that presides over all seen and unseen. The Son of Man. The Son of God. Jesus, also known as the Christ. By right he is King of Kings. And by his origins, he is the Lord of all. To his kingdom and reign there will be no end. So declares the God and Father of all. Unlike many earthly puppet kings, this Son of God is different. A God by being, however, chose to dwell with the sons of men, that he might pay their ransom and free them from the wrath which is soon to come. And having single-handedly purchased back our lost souls, he has returned to his throne in heaven, eagerly waiting for the time when all the kingdoms of heaven and earth will come together under his divine rule, as was promised by his Father and God. As it is written, "Who being the brightness of his glory, and the express image of his person, and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high." Hebrews chapter 1 verse 3. Again, "Having made known unto us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure which he hath purposed in himself, that in the dispensation of the fullness of times he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth, even in him." Ephesians chapter 1 verses 9 to 10. Whilst the King of Kings waits for the start of his final reign, he has committed his work to a select group here on earth. These ones fly his banner high. Their faith in him is unwavering.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.